Hello everyone, thanks a lot for clicking on this video. I'm Paco, and in this video we'll see the tools that you can use in order to make a game, even if you don't know how to code. As we will see later in this video, if you want to make games but you don't know how to code, the alternative for you is to use visual scripting tools in order to make your games. So visual scripting is a tool that enables you to see visually the program that you are creating for your game. So for instance, you can be dragging and dropping some blocks for some behavior and then connecting some dots between these blocks. So this makes the behavior of your complete video game. Probably a downside from these visual scripting tools is that some of them, as we'll see later in this video, you will have to pay a fee or to pay a package in order to use these visual scripting tools. I think if you don't know how to code or you don't like coding, then I think this is going to be a good option for you. In programming, there are different language levels. They are classified as low-level languages and high-level languages. When going from low-level languages to high-level languages, the level of abstraction increases. That means the higher the level of the language, it's closer to your human language and it's easier to understand for us. On the downside, when you go to the higher-level languages, you have less control of your code, meaning that you will have less efficiency and less control on the memory that you're using in your program. So as the base level, we have the hardware of the computer, we have switches and gates, and then the lowest programming language is the machine language, which is programming with zeros and ones. If you want to have full control of your code, this is a way to do it. You can program with zeros and ones. Then the next level, which is also a low level language, is assembly language. And from there, we go to higher level languages, which we can start with C, C++, Python, for instance, where the level of abstraction is closer to human language. Then we have visual scripting, which is a programming language that lets users create programs by manipulating program elements, meaning blocks or some graphical elements, rather than using text or code specifically. Hey, quick interruption here. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks. So with visual programming, you can use visual expressions, special arrangements of text, and graphic symbols. And any visual programming language is based on the idea of boxes and arrows, meaning that you are connecting boxes with arrows, where boxes are treated as entities connected by these arrows or lines, which these arrows and lines represent the relations between these objects. Now let's review the tools and softwares that you can use if you don't know how to code but you want to create games. And also most of these will use visual scripting tools. Feel free to check them out to see more details. The first one that we're going to check is Gamemaker Studio. This is a software that enables you to create 2D games. So they say that you can use a drag and drop development environment. This is their visual scripting tools that you can use instead of writing any code. As you can see, by using this software, you can export your game to desktop, web, mobile, and also to different consoles. Now, the downside is that in order to use this tool, you have to pay for it. And you can see that they offer different packages, the creator, developer, or the console. So the most expensive is using the console package, where you can export your video game to different consoles, for instance PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch. But then you can see that the price goes really high for having the license to export to consoles. Nevertheless, this software looks quite good. Yeah, I recommend you to check it out. Then the second software that I want to share with you is RPG Maker. This is also a quite popular tool that you can create your video game. This software is also mainly for 2D games. And you can see that it provides you with many tools. For instance, you can create your maps, your characters. It gives you a lot of tools to create your video game. And they have these plugins that they promise that it's going to be easier for you if you don't know how to code. This one also looks quite good. Also, for instance, you can see that if you want to publish your game, the license for it is covered with RPG Maker, so no additional commercial license is required. As I said before, with all these tools, most of the times you will have to pay an extra money in order to be able to use them. So for instance, this RPG Maker has a cost of 67 euros. But yeah, this is a popular and also good tool that you can use to create your games. Now let's check the game engines that support also visual scripting. The first one that we can check is Godot. This one has an API that enables you to write in code or also to use visual scripting. And you can see that you have here an example of the visual scripting tool that they have. The boxes, which are the entities, and the dots connected with lines representing the relations between them. So yeah, if you're using Godot, so you can also use scripting tools with this game engine. Then we have Unreal Engine. You can see here that they have something that they call blueprints for visual scripting. Here in the background, you can see that it's the same concept where you have boxes which represent some entities and the lines which represent the relations between them. So with this game engine, you have the possibility also to use the blueprints as a visual scripting tool if you don't like to code. Then Unity, which is the game engine that I'm using, you can see that there are many, many visual scripting tools that you can use within Unity. The option that I want to show you here is Playmaker. You can see here that this visual scripting tool has also the same concept, where you have some boxes and some lines which represent the relations between them, and you can create the actions for your game. You can see here that this tool, you have to pay it, but I see that it's quite popular within Unity. I wanted to show specifically this visual scripting tool because one channel that I follow, which is Gamedev Unlocked, this guy, he tells him within his videos that he was not good at programming. So he had a lot of struggles trying to make video games. And then he used this tool, Playmaker, to create the behavior and the program of his video game. And then he was really successful creating his game, which is named The First Tree. You can see that it's really beautiful video game. He's more on the artistic side. And you can see that this is a really good example that someone who has more artistic skills, he was able to use this scripting tool, and then he was able to create a beautiful game. So this is a very good example of the benefits of having also visual scripting tools as an option for creative video games. So as we saw from Game Dev Unlocked, if you are not used to coding or you have struggles with coding, please take a look into these visual scripting tools. We saw that different game engines or outside the game engines, you can have these options to create visual programming for your video game. So yeah, don't be locked by these. You can please check these tools that I shared. Probably there are more, so yeah, take a look into what you can use. So if this video was in any sense helpful for you, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and we'll keep uploading videos like this. So see you until the next time. Thanks.